Hello everyone, thanks for joining me in the Allen Block workshop to learn about what it takes to successfully construct your Allen Block retaining wall project. What I will walk you through today are the steps you're going to take when constructing a gravity wall. This video picks up after you've properly installed, backfilled, and compacted your first course of block. If you haven't already, check out our base course and backfill and compaction videos to ensure you follow those important initial steps for proper retaining wall construction. Now let's head out back to our sandbox so I can show you. A gravity wall is a lower height wall that does not need reinforcement due to site or soil conditions. However, just because it is a shorter wall, how you construct it will ensure it does not overturn or settle years later. If you need help, please refer to our installation manuals found on our website. These will help you to identify when your project may be built as a gravity wall or if it will need reinforcement. It is always a good idea to check your local code requirements. So for your gravity wall, we will start by placing on top of the prepared base course the next course of blocks. As a trick, slide each block into place to remove any debris that may be present on the base course. Have the bottom notch tight against that front lip of the blocks below. Running bond is ideal for offsetting the vertical seams. If running bond is not possible, offset them by at least a quarter of the block and set them flush against the front edge of the blocks below. Check blocks for level as installed, from side to side and front to back. Make minor adjustments with a dead blow hammer as needed. Use a longer level as you go to span several blocks to ensure proper alignment. Once the second course is in place, sight down the wall to make sure the wall is straight. Fill the hollow cores in 12 inches behind the block with wall rock. Use a flat nose shovel to remove the excess wall rock from the top of the blocks, then backfill behind the wall rock using approved on-site soils and rake smooth. Run a mechanical plate compactor over the top of the blocks to compact the wall rock in the block cores. Then compact behind the blocks in a path parallel to the wall, making a minimum of 2 passes. Remove any excess material from the top surface of the blocks by sweeping the blocks clean with a broom. This prepares a smooth surface for the next course. Continue these steps per course to the top of your gravity wall. So let's review what we have covered for gravity wall installation. On a prepared base course, slide the second course of block in place with the bottom notch tight against the front lip of the base course. Make sure the block seams are offset by at least a quarter of the block length. Check for level, side to side and front to back. Sight down the wall and make any adjustments needed. You will then fill the cores in 12 inches behind the wall with wall rock and backfill with on-site soils. Then, rake smooth and using a mechanical plate compactor, compact the entire area starting directly on the top of the block and work into the backfill area. Make a minimum of 2 passes. Keep all heavy equipment at least 3 feet away from the back of the blocks. Always compact in 8-inch lifts or less, the height of one full-sized block. Continue these steps to the top of your wall and finish with the caps. Why do you need a gravity wall? Think of the small wall applications like a tree ring, a raised planter, or a small patio wall to create the flat area or countless other applications that these small accent walls can be used for. Just because they do not need reinforcement, we still need to ensure they are done correctly. By following this simple process, you will construct a proper gravity wall that will stand the test of time. For taller wall applications, please see the reinforced wall section or visit us at allenblock.com. Happy building! Always better, always Allen Block.